Good afternoon, everybody. In the past 2 weeks, the number of cases of COVID-19 outside China has increased 13-fold, and the number of affected countries has tripled. There are now more than 118,000 cases in 114 countries, and 4,291 people have lost their lives.
Jumbo planes taking a ride on a cosmic train. Switch on summer from a slot machine. Just get what you want if you want.
What sort of changes have you seen that on a normal day you wouldn't really appreciate as much or kind of be as thankful for, or just like something that you notice more often that kind of brightens your day?
I think even when I'm busy, I'm in a mindset of how can I slow down and like appreciate what's around me. I think just over the last year, I've conditioned myself to do that because I know it's important. And, like, that's how, genuinely, like, I rarely have, like, a bad day where, like, I'm like, man, my life sucks, because there's always something good. But specifically being by myself and, like, I've been trying to limit technology a lot because, in my opinion, it's kind of detrimental right now. And, like, I know it's important to stay connected, but it feels like a trap. So I've been trying to stay away from that. And just, like, going on runs without my phone for, like, 5 miles and just, like, going early in the morning, no one's out, there's a pandemic, and just, like, hearing my feet move and, like, I'm breathing the air back. It's just, like, very simple things where I'm, like, oh, my gosh, like, I'm alive and I'm running. And I've been running for, like, more than one day a week now, so I actually feel good while I'm running, like, that sort of feeling I've been really in touch with lately. I definitely feel the absence of human connection. Like I said, I'm 50-50 extrovert, introvert, and I love being by myself. I have no problem with that, but I also need people, as everyone needs people, and I miss having that, at least like the tangible form of it. And yeah, I mean, in terms of drastic changes, I still notice the same, like, little things. I still, like, notice the sounds outside and, like, the sweet old people in Five Points and the manners of everyone. I was on a walk the other day, and the houses in Five Points are, like, these amazing, like, houses. They look like they're straight out of Southern Living, so they have these, like, sweet little families in them. And this one house is this epic tree house in the backyard, and this little boy was, like, fishing from it, like, over grass. And I was like, that's cool. And then his, like, little sister ran past the yard, zero chance of rain, like, it was all blue skies, and she had these huge, like, red rain boots on, and she was just, like, running around. And, like, while I was on my walk, this whole family passed me on their bikes, and, like, that's the sort of thing I would still put a lot of value on even when I was busy. So I don't think that's changed, but it still means a lot.
And then give it on us.
I think that, like, situations like these, like, I feel like in life in general, or, like, in your own life, or, I like, globally, since this is happening, like, all over, I feel like it kind of teaches us and makes you realize, like, the things you take for granted in life. And, like, I think a big thing is going to be, like, real human contact and the importance of that. Because if you think about it, like, not even just with young people, like, it happens, like, with all different ages, but, like, if you go to a restaurant, like, the amount of times people will, like, pull their phone out during a meal or, like, be waiting for their food and, like, the whole family's on their phone, or, like, in a group setting with friends, like, you're just on your phone. And I think that this has kind of taught me, like, okay, here's, like, besides, like, being with your family, like, here's all the time you would ever need to be on your phone. So when this is all over, like, don't be on it. Because you, like, you need to, like, take advantage of these opportunities, because something like this could happen again and it could be a lot worse. And I think it's taught me, and I can see it teaching other people, like, the importance of just, like, doing things with people, talking to people, however it may be, but, like, making it genuine communication, and not just, like, texting. Like, writing letters has been really good, and, like, giving me this, like, substitute of, like, meaningful communicating with people. And I can see from, like, other people I've talked to that, like, people just realize, you know, like, I miss just, like, seeing and sitting down and talking with people. So I hope that some good, that good will come with this, for people to realize, like, your phone is not that important. You, like, it's always going to be there, but, like, people aren't always going to be there around you, and you need to take advantage of that and, like, connect with people and, like, just communicate in a good and healthy way.
Yeah, I definitely think that people are going to realize that, like, we kind of need that break, like I mentioned. I think people are going to realize that we're also human and that we can't solve all of our problems, and that, you know, nature and the environment overall will win, because, I mean, the disease is going on technically is an aspect and an element of nature.
Yeah.
And, like, our environment. And I think people, I don't think it'll be as big of a change as we're hoping for, but I think people definitely have an understanding of what needs to be done. You know, I think we'll have a better appreciation.
Absolutely.
Just because it's been a long time at home, you know?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's that, like, sitting inside.
But I just feel like all the benefits we're seeing are temporary, because it's, like, a lack of human. It's not, like, we're making a, like, a purposeful difference for the environment. It's kind of, like, we just stopped doing what we're doing, and we're seeing, like, small but good temporary benefits. But when all of this is over, we're going to see those benefits disappear. Like, there's been a lot of talk about, like, air pollution clearing up, and, like, that's really good, obviously, but, like, I feel like it will go away, and, like, people probably won't remember, like, the impact that, like, us not doing our normal thing had on the environment once, like, things become convenient again. So. It made me realize, like, okay, nature isn't just the mountains or the beach. Like, it's not, like, a destination. And I hope that's what other people are realizing too, is that it's, like, as cheesy as it sounds, it's your backyard, it's your front yard.